Dr. Shivam signing in, and I hope you have started giving your extra effort every day so as to be a better version of you from your previous one. So you have to compete by yourself. That means your only competitor is you and not anyone else. So you have to try to be a better version of you. Okay, so start giving something extra, some extra effort, start crossing your limits. So these are, in this video, I'll discuss some of the very important picture MCQs that are must for you all. And they are going to ask something from this video. So please, I know you are very busy, but still I will want your 5 minutes for this video so that you don't miss which everyone other aspirants are knowing. And this is something which everyone will be knowing. And if you miss this, it will count as a silly mistake for you. Okay. So please concentrate here. This is a immunofluorescence microscopy picture of acute proliferative glomerulonephritis. So basically you should know how to differentiate between different glomerulonephritis by seeing this immunofluorescence picture. And this I'll make you clear. See, in this picture you can see there are granular immunofluorescence characteristic of immune complex mediated nephritis. So if you see these small dots, granules like a structure, so it is basically acute proliferative glomerulonephritis. Now I will move to other immunofluorescence picture also, but see the acute proliferative glomerulonephritis immunofluorescence microscopy is this. But if you take the electron microscopy, how it will look, I'll show you. So this is the electron microscopy where the characteristic feature is electron dense subepithelial humps, as you can see here. So these are the electron dense subepithelial hump. If they give you this picture of electron microscopy, so you be sure that it is acute proliferative glomerulonephritis. And I hope you will not make it wrong now. Now another thing is anti-GBM immunofluorescence microscopy. That is the good partials. Now you can differentiate it from the previous picture. In previous picture, we have seen some dotted picture, but here we can see one linear immunofluorescence which is characteristic of anti-GBM or good partial syndrome. Okay, now you can picturize it. These are the linear patterns. You see the linear patterns, so it is characteristic of good partial anti-GBM disease. Now you will mark it right, I think. Another thing is membranous glomerulonephritis. The picture here they will give is the silver stain. What you can see here is it reveals multiple spikes distributed in the glomerular capillary basement membrane. See the picture here. So you can see different multiple spikes here, here and here. So these are basically the multiple spikes in the glomerular basement membrane. And the appearance is produced due to deposition of silver positive basement membrane material around the silver negative immune complex deposit. So this is of membranous glomerulonephritis. So now this is something which every one of you must be knowing, and if you are not knowing, that means you are lacking somewhere, because this is one of the repeated question. Okay, so this is from the molluscum contagiosum showing the epidermal hyperplasia with cell having ellipsoidal cytoplasm, that is the molluscum bodies within the stratum granulosum and the stratum corneum. This is not clue cell, okay? This is Wharton-Finkelday's giant cell. I will show you how the clue cells look like. So this is present in the measles, HIV infected individuals and the Kimura disease. How they look? These are just like a grape-like cluster of nuclei with eosinophilic viral inclusion in both the nuclei as well as in the cytoplasm. They stain fine pink, stippled dotted, as you can see it here. Now this is something for the diagnosis of rabies, that means Negri bodies. And something which has been already asked is the Negri bodies are seen in hippocampus, brainstem and the cerebellum, basically in the Purkinje neurons. And what is the most common site? It is the cerebellum, asked in the West Bengal PG exam. So you must be knowing this, and now you will make it correct. The picture is of rabies, Negri bodies, okay? This is something very frequently asked in your Neetpg exam, that is Barrett esophagus. So they have already asked by giving picture. Now you can see it and make it in your mind that this is a picture of Barrett esophagus. In the image A, you can see the goblet cells interspread between the mucus cells and this one. And the in the second picture, it is both, it is showing that it is both past positive and Alcyon blue positive. The second picture, the now picture, it is showing clue cell having a stippled appearance due to bacteria covered with the epithelial cells caused, seen in bacterial vaginosis due to Gardnerella vaginosis. This you all know. Now this is another thing where they can ask the immunofluorescence and the histopathology picture. So this is bullous pemphigoid, okay, showing the subepidermal blister and inflammatory infiltrate, typically polymorphous with an eosinophilic preponderance. What you need to remember is this linear band of immunoglobulin G, which is deposit along the dermoepidermal junction in the ribbon candy for pattern. So this is bullous pemphigoid. You will not forget it. Dermatitis herpetiformis, another important topic where the subepidermal blisters are associated with accumulation of neutrophils, that is the microabscess at the tip of dermal papillae, and the immunofluorescence is very characteristic. You can see IgA deposits at the dermal papilla tips, so you will also not going to make it wrong. This is something which is a new pattern type of question they may give you, that this is the polarized microscopy picture of Koongo red staining showing the amyloid. So this is basically what you all know, the apple green birefringence under the polarized microscopy. Another important thing what they have already asked is different cast and the stones in the urine. So I'll in fast I will go through them. The hyaline casts look like this. They are seen in the normal individual, heavy exercise and in dehydration. The muddy brown cast looks like this, seen in the acute tubular necrosis. These are some stones like calcium oxalate monohydrate stone. Okay, so how they are seen, these are the dumbbell like stones seen in the hypercalciuric or hyperoxaluric disorders or the ethylene glycol poisoning. So this is calcium oxalate monohydrate, which is dumbbell shaped. Okay, I'll move to the calcium oxalate dihydrate, which is envelope shaped. So monohydrate is dumbbell, dihydrate is envelope shaped. Okay, remember it, you will not make it wrong. So it is basically dihydrate is caused due to high dietary oxalate ingestion and ethylene glycol poisoning and nephrolithiasis, you all know. Now another stone which is important is the struvite stone or the struvite crystal, that is the magnesium ammonium phosphate or the triple phosphate. So these are like coffin lid. They have been already asked in some of the exams, so you need to revise them. Okay, so these are basically by the in the UTI by the urea splitting bacterias. So wish you all the very best. As I get time, I'll make some more important stuff for you. So stay updated. Do like, comment and share. By your likes and comment, I get the feedback and I find time so that it might help you. Okay, thank you. And do give your extra effort. This is the right time. Okay, thank you.